No!
How about this? The U.S. Park Police are...
What's going on, everyone? So welcome to my latest video. This is, of course, part of a series where I focus on a specific director and rank that director's work from worst to best. Done such directors in the past, such as Spike Jones, Spike Lee, David Fincher, David Lynch, Wes Anderson. The list goes on. You guys can check out that playlist down below. But guys, you clicked on this video, so you know it. This time around, I'm focusing on Paul Greengrass's films, and I'm ranking them from worst to best. He's on 10 films, so I will be doing number 10 being his worst, number 1 being his best, and of course, my opinion. This will not be including any short films, video games, TV shows, music videos, none of that. Just specifically his films. So, guys, all that exposition aside, let's get started. So, kicking things off with my number 10, we have Green Zone. This movie is quite disappointing, not gonna lie, and forgettable. It's not really worth talking about it, because as soon as you're done watching this movie, it literally dissipates from your memory. Not gonna lie. That's why it's my number 10. Next up, my number 9 is The Theory of Flight. Not gonna lie, this movie was very hard to track down. I think that this movie is overly sentimental, but I gotta give Greengrass props where props is due. He did a movie that was overly sentimental, and he would later on be known for doing these like visceral, intense thrillers. So I give him props for the range, honestly. I think the movie has its heart in the right place, but again, the overly sentimental, you know, hogwash feelings that I got watching it left a bad taste in my mouth, but I don't think this is a bad movie, per se. I definitely see that there's an audience out there, but unfortunately, the audience doesn't really have a way of watching it, unfortunately. I hope that it does hit, like, a streaming platform, maybe, so that way people can catch it. Not a bad movie. This personally wasn't up my alley, but I can definitely understand and appreciate why some people might like this movie. But, yeah, that's why it's my number 9. Next up, number 8, speaking of going out of the wheelhouse, number 8 is News of the World. This is a Western film. Very different, obviously, from the previous entry, which was an overly sentimental movie. So, Greengrass has great range. But, unfortunately, for News of the World, besides one action scene, Tom Hanks' really good performance, and an immaculate production design, I found this movie to be very dull. James Newton Howard's score, it's not bad, per se, but I just wasn't really vibing with it. The pacing is overly slow. I love Westerns, I really do, but I just could not jam with this movie. Maybe I'll revisit it at some point, but I just wasn't a big, big fan. I have this a little bit higher than The Theory of Flight just simply because The News of the World is better in terms of the filmmaking. But in terms of enjoyment, it's going to vary, obviously. But they're pretty close, neck and neck. But News of the World, if you like it, I can definitely understand and respect that. I just personally wasn't jamming with the movie. But that's why it's my number 8. Next up, my number 7 is... You ready for this? Jason Bourne. Now, I know what you guys are thinking, because Jason Bourne, I do have a review on my channel for it. I saw it when it came out 5 years ago. And I liked it when I saw it in theaters, but I rewatched it because I got the entire, you know, Bourne series. I almost said the Bourne trilogy. The entire Bourne series, because I was like, you know, it was like $40 for all 5. I was like, yeah, it gives me an excuse to finally revisit Jason Bourne. And I have to say, after revisiting Jason Bourne, it definitely is not a 4 out of 5 star movie the way I thought it was 5 years ago. I found myself to be very mixed about this movie. I appreciate the action. I appreciate Greengrass's directing and the performances, but unfortunately, it is definitely a retread of other entries in this series, which is unfortunate because I couldn't help but think during a lot of these scenes, oh, I could have just been watching the other entries that Greengrass did in this series. So it's a shame. I definitely understand why some people might like this movie, but I feel very mixed about it. I don't know if I'll ever revisit it again. I mean, who knows? I own this box set, so you never know. But yeah, Jason Bourne, it's my number 7. Next up, number 6 is Bloody Sunday. This is even more so up the alley of Greengrass because this is a based on true story movie. His directing here is very competent. I definitely see that this is like an early entry of what he would later on do in other based on true story visceral thrillers. This movie, I think, is okay. I definitely respect and appreciate what he was going for and how he tackled it. I just personally wasn't able to fully be engaged watching this movie. I found myself kind of distracted watching it. I don't know. It's hard to explain with this movie. It's not bad, per se. Again, I thought it was okay, but I do think that there were some technical aspects I wasn't the biggest fan of, but overall, I definitely think that this is one of the better entries on this list in terms of the other ones I mentioned, just simply because of the messages and themes, and again, the subject matter that he's tackling with all this. So, I give Bloody Sunday props for that, and that's why it's a bit higher up on this list at number 6. Next up, number 5 is... The Bourne Supremacy. This was the second entry in the Bourne series and the first entry that Paul Greengrass directed. And it feels a lot different from The Bourne Identity, which makes sense because it's two different directors. But I gotta say, Bourne Supremacy is very entertaining. It's got that visceral, intense, action scenes that best describe the series and is best known for. It's got that incredible score. You know, and we have that directing of the shaky camera work with the cinematography that works really well. Sometimes it's a bit too shaky. I will give people props for that because I know a lot of people kind of complain about that. But I think overall, it's a really unique style that I think works. He's one of the few directors that's able to pull it off. And I do like The Bourne Supremacy. I like it quite a bit. And that is why it is number 5. Next up, I gotta say it. Next up, my number 4 is 22 July. I'm kicking myself. I watched this actually yesterday on 9/11. I have to kick myself because this movie came out in 2018. And I remember being excited to watch it on Netflix, but unfortunately, I think because of Oscar season, I was watching other movies and going to the movies a lot. So it just kind of got put back on my watch list of Netflix. I kept looking at it and seeing that it was on Netflix. But for some reason, over the years, I just kind of was looking at it. I was like, oh, it's so long though. And I kept putting it off. And it's a detriment. I really think that that's something that I shouldn't have done because this is a very good movie. I really liked this movie. It's very hard to watch. It's very visceral. It's intense. And it's definitely like a 2-for-1 kind of combo pack because you have that visceral, intense, hard to watch first half. And then the second half, it shifts into like a courtroom film. I personally was fine with that shift, but I definitely see why some people might not be fine with that. But I think it's a very good movie. And honestly, It opened my eyes. You know, I didn't know about this event, so I give this movie props for that. I definitely see why some people might not like this movie, but I personally really like this movie. I got a lot out of it, and might not be a film I watch anytime soon, but I definitely will revisit it down the line because how can I not? It's very well crafted. So that's my number 4. Next up, my number 3 is Captain Phillips. I love Captain Phillips. I saw this in theaters, and I've seen it many times. I actually used to own it on DVD, and I saw it several times on DVD, and then when I bought it on Blu-ray, I've seen it several times since. I love this film. I think that Tom Hanks gives one of his best performances. I think, again, that whole visceral thriller feeling of, like, based on a true story and just kind of throwing us as the audience into the action. It's very smart. Honestly, I feel like more based on true story movies should do that because Greengrass makes it work really well. Like, you feel like you're immersed in this world because you're just thrown into it and you just kind of are immersed by everything that's going on. I love it. It helps also that it's got a great screenplay, but if you haven't seen Captain Phillips for some reason, I would highly recommend it. Definitely one of the best films of the 2010s, and Greengrass should be very proud, especially the last 10 minutes. Holy cow. Amazing. But yeah, that is my number 3. Next up, my number 2 is, let's pull it out of the case. My number 2 is The Bourne Ultimatum. My favorite Bourne film out of the 5, hands down, but also one of my favorite Greengrass films. This movie is near perfection. I think it is one of the best action films out there. And everything that Greengrass loves to do, he puts in this movie, and you are never once bored. This movie constantly knows when to have downtime and when to have that frenetic action. It's a really good character study, but also a really good action thriller and at the same time political espionage type film. I really appreciate this film. I love it. I've seen it many, many times, and it looks really good on 4K. I would highly recommend it. I can't recommend it enough. Not gonna lie, this was actually my number 1 film of Greengrass's for a while, but I rewatched my number 1, and my number 1 is United 93. I gotta give Greengrass props. This movie is his masterpiece. I think that The Bourne Ultimatum and Captain Phillips are near masterpieces. Like, I give both around a 4.75 out of 5, but United 93, I gotta give it to him, a 5 out of 5. This movie does everything right with his style. It's the perfect blending of style, realism, and just fact-basing. And I love this film. I think it's incredible. This film is so incredible that literally the last piece of music that is in this movie is literally utilized again in Captain Phillips because Greengrass knew that that piece is very effective. This movie, it's not easy watch, and I'm not gonna lie, I reviewed this film 5 years ago on my channel, and I hadn't watched it since, but I watched it obviously in 9/11 for the 20-year anniversary, and especially because I knew I was gonna be doing this ranking list, I felt like I owe it to myself to revisit it. I've seen it only 3 times in the past, like, what, 7 years, so it's definitely not a movie I watch a lot, but it's definitely a movie that when I think about it, I do get sad. I also just can't help but think about the thought-provoking nature of this film and also how it's one of the best based on true story films. If you haven't watched United 93, I would highly recommend it. Although, to sensitive viewers, I do have to preface this. It's not an easy watch, for sure. But yeah, that is my number 1. And guys, that is my list for Paul Greengrass. Now, I do like to talk a little bit about the director afterwards, so I'll mention this. Greengrass, I think that he's a very good director. I love his utilization of cinematography. His directing style is really cool. He's one of the few directors that actually make shaky camera work. He's done a lot for the based on true story genre. And honestly, I give him props for that, because making a based on true story movie and making it interesting and not feel cliche is hard enough. But he makes it his own, and he really is a breath of fresh air. And also, he's got a lot of range. As I mentioned, a lot of these movies aren't even action thrillers. Some of them are sentimental movies. Some of them are Western. So I give him props, and I am a huge fan of his. And honestly, if he's doing a movie anytime soon, you best believe I'll be there day one. So yeah, guys, that's my ranking of Paul Greengrass's films. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, as well as your ranking down below. And as always, guys, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the subscription, notification bell, and I'll catch you guys later.